Good morning friends, welcome to Aware Computers. In last video we discussed about primary memory. In this video I am going to explain about secondary memory. What is secondary memory? How many types? These things we will discuss in this video. Before going to discuss the secondary memory, once again we have to discuss about computer memory. What is computer memory? How many types? These things we will discuss. Coming to computer memory. Memory is used to store internally in the computer. It is used to store the information either permanently or temporarily. Computer memory can be classified into two types. Those are primary memory and secondary memory. About primary memory, we already discussed in the previous video. Now I am going to explain about secondary memory. What is secondary memory? How many types? These things we'll discuss in this video. Coming to secondary memory. Secondary memory is also known as permanent memory or external memory or non-volatile memory or auxiliary memory. Once again, I am telling, secondary memory is also known as permanent memory or external memory or non-volatile memory or auxiliary memory. What about primary memory? Primary memory is also known as temporary memory or volatile memory. And also, secondary memory is used to store the data permanently. The secondary storage devices stores data even when the computer is switched off. For example, hard disk. Coming to types of secondary memory. Types of secondary memory is as follows. Those are floppy disk, CD-ROM, DVD, hard disk, CDRW, magnetic tapes, USB flash drives, memory cards. Today I am going to explain about floppy disk, CD-ROM, DVD and hard disk. The remaining concepts we will discuss in the next video. Coming to floppy disk. What is floppy disk? The duration of floppy disk is 1970 to 2000. That time the size of floppy is only 8 inches. And also the storage capacity is 100 KB. So 100 KB means what? 100 kilobytes. So very less storage capacity because it accepts only one side data storage. That's why the storage capacity is very less. After some days, floppy was redesigned as it accepts the data both sides. The next time the size of floppy is 5.25 inches or 3.5 inches. After then, see the floppy, how it look like. The duration is 1970 to 2000. After redesign the floppy disk, the storage capacity was increased. So what is the storage capacity of floppy disk? That means the storage capacity of floppy disk is only 1.44 MB. So 1.44 MB means what? 1.44 megabytes. It is also less capacity, but comparing first, that means 100 KB, it is somewhat better. Floppy disk are used to store the data permanently, and also it is a portable device. Using floppy disk, we can transfer the files from one computer to another computer. Coming to CD-ROM. CD-ROM stands for Compact Disk Read-Only Memory. It is a type of optical disk. And also it uses laser technology to store the information. It is also portable device. See the CD-ROM, how it looks like. So carefully observe here, 700 MB. What is 700 MB? The capacity of CD. The capacity of CD-ROM is 700 MB to 1 GB. It accepts the data storage is only one time. That means it accepts only one time of data storage. Multiple times data storage is not acceptable. And also we can't do any modifications which is stored in CD-ROM. Coming to DVD-ROM. So what is DVD? DVD-ROM stands for Digital Video Disc or Digital Versatile Disk Read-Only Memory. It is also type of optical disk, and also it is also uses laser technology to store the information, and also it is portable device. These are widely used to store the movies, large databases, complex softwares, etc. Because the capacity of DVD is very big, that means 4.7 GB to 17 GB. So what is GB? GB means what? That is gigabytes. So the capacity of DVD is 4.7 gigabytes to 17 gigabytes. It accepts the data storage is only one time, like CD. Multiple time data storage, it is also not acceptable. And also, we can't do any modifications on which is stored in DVD-ROM. Coming to hard disk. Hard disk is a part of the computer. In a computer, all the information is stored in the hard disk. If it is damaged, all the data stored in the computer will be lost. See, look like hard disk, how it look like. The capacity of hard disk is nowadays in gigabytes or terabytes. It is fixed in the CPU. We can read and write the data which is stored in hard disk. That means we can edit how many times we want the information stored in the hard disk. If you like this video, please.